This is Mark Sutton from the University of California, San Francisco's IT Web Services Department, here today with a brief tour of screen reading technology. I'm a blind person who has been using screen readers, braille writers, scanning equipment, other adaptive technologies since my childhood. What a screen reader does is, for example, I'm going to start to read this page.
Navigation modem. Link, University of California, San Francisco. Link, about UCSF. Link, search UCSF.
And what I will now do is slow down the speech rate.
Rate 80%, 75%, 70%, 65%, 60%, 55%, 50%, 45%, 40%. Link, UCSF Medical Center.
So as I was about to say, a screen reader converts what's on a computer screen into information that can be displayed through synthetic speech or braille output. And it does that by allowing you to use a computer instead of a mouse, a computer keyboard instead of a mouse. You can also use a braille display as an input device.
End of navigation.
And what it does is it cleverly determines what's on the screen and presents you that information in a way that would allow for efficient navigation of these pages. So for example, I could just keep reading.
Banner three items. Visited, link, image, home.
Line by line, and we could be here all day. Or I could jump to the first heading on the page.
Heading level two, search for heading level two. You are here. Heading level one, make videos accessible.
So as I'm moving down through the page, I can look for the category that interests me. And I'm just using commands built into the screen reader. So that's all pretty simple description of what a screen reader is all about. Now I'm going to go over and show a few examples of how that can fall apart. So I have a couple graphics on this page.
Mark Sutton hands on a MacBook Pro image.
So the first one is well described and uses an alt tag.
You are currently on it.
To describe what that graphic is all about. Now we go to the next graphic.
Reader 042116.jpg.
Much less useful. So it's important to use those elements. It's also true for tables, so I'm going to move to a table.
FDA approved medications, table, three columns, five rows, FDA approved medications, table.
So the table is pretty self-explanatory, and I'm going to move into the table.
Medicine, approved, column two of three.
And then if I go down into the table,
medicine, tolbutamide,
and as I move across,
three. Approved, 1975, column two of three.
We're getting the labels for the column headers and row headers. So it's important when programming tables, forms, and other elements on the web pages to use the proper HTML codes. I'll go to the
table three columns.
Second table on the page.
Medicine, row two of five, tolbutamide.
And as I'm in the table, I move across it.
Row, November 1995.
I get a date, but I don't know what that date is associated with. So it's important, as I was saying, to include proper coding tags for all these elements. These are just a few highlights of a screen reader's capabilities and some of the ways in which the experience can fall short for a blind user. The life of students, faculty, staff, and visitors is largely conducted on the internet nowadays. Screen reading technologies can make many of these interactions work more smoothly. When developers pay attention to certain coding standards, blind persons are able to participate in digital communication, being able to do such things as understand calendars and schedules, enroll in or teach classes, conduct research, and many more essential activities that are conducted electronically. If developers of web pages and applications fail to take into account these design considerations, many people will be left out, unable to use these tools of daily life that are now taken for granted by most of us. The university provides a gateway to many key aspects of social participation. It's imperative that access to university offerings is not jeopardized. For more information, go to digitalaccess.ucsf.edu. Thank you.